right there? Has he got that right? Got that right, Jamie?
Yeah, you can't lose it.
Is that or the top of your head? Be better, wouldn't it?
Yeah,
oh, that way.
Probably, no, Billy's got his. No,
has
the
he?
Other way.
Oh, you feel like
today?
Bill Gaines is fine.
He's a good boy.
Maureen, how are you?
Oh, good, thanks. How are you, Maureen?
Did you put Grandpa's hair on?
Yeah.
I did.
Oh, you need to reckon this.
It looks nice.
Where's Grandpa's ring?
Like me here.
Oh, Grandpa, I haven't got a wee one.
Grandpa, let's put another ring
here. Do you want another one to put there?
There's still some more on the floor.
Where's, oh, this time he got a haircut.
Where's,
in the black and white there. See my barb with the... Hey, are we meant to be
seeing you?
No.
We're not.
Right, Ella? It's quite a long song, so I think I'm actually next here. She'll probably stand here for the verse. Strange.
Always together, together forever. Always together forever. I will love you till the day I die. I know it now, my love won't run dry. You came along, my life has begun. I know.
We've come together to witness and to share in the joy of the marriage of Kim and Bill, the union of man and woman in heart, body and mind is intended for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in good times and bad, and marriage is a most important and sacred bond existing between two people. In this ceremony, Bill and Kim give witness to their mutual love and understanding and come now to entrust themselves to each other in the demanding but rewarding relationship of marriage. This means learning truly and deeply to accept each other. It suggests that you two must develop the courage to grow and change together, the strength to accept what cannot and will not be changed in each other, and the wisdom and common sense to know the difference. Acceptance of each other means loving the whole person through satisfying and frustrating experiences of life. This is hard, but it's crucial in developing mature love. Marriage is not the submersion of one and the other, but exists for the benefit of you both. It enables you two separate people to share your desires and longings and dreams and memories and to help each other through your uncertainties. It provides support and encouragement in the things you consider to be worthwhile. And in this increasingly deepening relationship, in association with each other, it points to your mutual fulfillment. Therefore, accepting their love and obligations to each other, Kim and Bill now ask to be joined together as husband and wife. Bill, do you love and trust Kim and take her as your wife and marriage? Are you willing to stand by her no matter what happens, to respect her, understand her needs, accept her changes, and enjoy her love until death comes? Love and trust Bill and take him as your husband and wife. Are you willing to stand by him no matter what happens, to respect him, understand his needs, accept his changes, and enjoy his love until death comes?
to where's my ring?
Kim has written a love poem for the occasion, Valentine's Day, written for herself and for Bill, and these are the words of their wedding day poem. Where love grows, life is gentle, life is sweet. The happiness that hoped for is complete. Where love grows, every day is bright and fair, and every evening brings new dreams to share. There's a wisdom only the heart knows. True beauty may be found where true love grows. The happiness I've found with you, the laughter that we share, our special times together, just knowing that you care. The thoughtful little things you do in such a loving way. You're someone very special who has truly made an art of living first for others and of sharing from the heart. The story of your kindness, it's the sweetest ever told. There's far more love for you, sweetheart, than ever could be told. Your hand that touches mine to say, I love you, babe. Happy Valentine's Day. Tim and Bill, you've declared your commitment to each other and have symbolized this by joining hands and giving rings. You've also expressed love and affection to each other and your hopes for your future together. You're aware that such a deep personal relationship is not easily attained and there will be times when it will be difficult. Such times recall the sincerity of the vows you've made today. Your friends here share with you their faith in your relationship and know there will also be times of great joy and they will be glad with you. You have made sacred promises to each other. In the spirit of these promises, I declare you husband and wife. Treasure this trust, love, and responsibility, and this full of mixed love to you. Well, we have... Again, three times. Just your usual signature. Come and congratulate them, and then they'll have their photos taken.
You look lovely. Congratulations, Billy. We've got you in the family at last.
Well done,
Oh, so
nice.
Nice. Yeah.
Do you have any of those from other women now?
We'll pay you a wedding.
Sorry.
Hey, Rich. Yeah, thanks, buddy.
Hey, Rich.
Oh, here's Dawn.
There he is.
Thanks, George. Yeah, very good, mate. Thanks, see ya.
Yeah.
All right.
Congratulations.
Thanks, girl, mate. Oh, this your mate?
Yeah.
Thanks, Dad.
Yeah, I thought so. Yeah, I've seen you before. Yeah. Very nice. Yeah.
And Mr. Riley. You're a wanky neighbour.
Yes.
Do you need some anti-window cream?
Oh, definitely do, yeah.
No, I'll just take him in.
sit with you.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Grew up with
him.
Stephen
James.
They would come from you for a while, don't they?
Huh?
Oh. It's very nice, isn't it?
No.
Right.
Well,
I
didn't want to lose the key, you see. Now I'm pulling from the key.
We've come to say congratulations. So good.
You look lovely.
Could you mind us how?
Hello, girls.
Oh, you look gorgeous. Can you really do? So pretty.
I thought you were going to post it. But I was going to post it.
It's beautiful.
Do you know that baby's in the UMA? They look hot on.
Well, there goes. They've got to go away shortly.
He's flying to Wellington.
Where's the photographer? Please.
I didn't realise it
was going
on.
Yeah.
Who's leaving? Hi.
This is my yangy.
I need a smoke.
Joe,
I introduced all my friends after.
We're going to get over here, darling.
What about my father?
Well, right, well, I'm going to do all that as soon as I can get this area.
Can somebody tell me? Yeah, one of the cousins up.
Jimmy.
Sorry.
You're a special one, aren't you?
Yes.
Thank you. Mr. Rex.
Yeah, look at him. Daddy's new ring, right?
Jimmy. Jump up.
See the man with the camera over there?
Yep.
I'll finish it with the cards.
I'll move my looks again.
I was smiling, isn't it?
Corner. Look towards it, if you would. Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Here we go. Oh, that's good. Okay, done. Right.
Mum and Dad, please. You are not
sorry. Ellen. Ellen. I knew we went to work for a week
after.
Get up and go back for a while.
Do you have a voice for a while,
Let me close.
Thank you, sir. Okay.
They say with years of
thank you.
please.
So you've got
to... You're supposed to be holding your flowers. Your flowers.
Oh.
Hold the flowers in this hand. In this hand. Just there. Right? And you'll just do it like that. And you'll have me look back.
Just
hand on the waist, hand there, and then you're looking around the corner too. Okay? That's great. Yes, that's good. Okay, let me just get my light, measurement strength. That's fine.
Please.
I need to see that.
Karen, look at the
camera. Me!
I just want to look down. That's a girl. Hold on there.
No. I can't even move.
It doesn't matter. It's enough. You don't want to excite people too much. Hello, I want the two fellas, please.
Thank you.
To make a speech to toast the bride and the groom, and I'm very happy to do so, because I'm one of those people who likes weddings. That is not surprising, because, like this lady here, my job, or part of my job, is handling weddings at the sign of the Takahi. And unfortunately, my venue was a bit too small for this large wedding, and so Billy wisely chose Mona Vale, which I think is possibly the most magnificent site in Christchurch, and certainly a splendid place to celebrate such a happy occasion as he's celebrating today. Now, these are my notes. It looks as though I'm going to present a sermon or a dissertation, but I've known Billy for so long, I have so many notes, I'm just trying to decide what I should go to. A few weeks ago, at the sign of the Takahi, talking about weddings, we had a wedding where the bride and groom arrived in a horse and gig. And the bridesmaids arrived on a horse and gig as well. And everything went fine until they left to have their photographs taken. They moved off up Kashmir Hills just past the Takahi to have the photos taken and the horse stripped. So the horse went over, the bride and groom hung for dear life to the carriage, the groomsman jumped down to grab the horse, and probably a good case was presented for fitting seat belts to gigs for brides. But however, they got over everything. We don't expect anything wrong to go here today though. In another recent wedding, it was rather funny, we had the bride and groom were in their late 70s, and it was a white wedding, and the parson who conducted the wedding made a speech, and in his speech he said that because of the age of the bride and groom, it was really a marriage where companionship would be the main feature of the wedding. And as soon as he spoke, he was followed by a retired minister who was 85. He got to his feet with the aid of two walking sticks, and he started his speech off with the words, "Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me the greatest pleasure." Because of his age, he forgot what he's going to say next. The windows of the Takahi almost rattled with the laughter, and I thought to myself, well, if that's so for a man of 85, there's hope for me yet as well. I met Billy through his parents. His parents patronised a radio and television business I used to have, and over the years they patronised one or two businesses I've owned, including the Takahi, where they dined quite recently. It would also be fair to say that I've patronised one or two businesses that Billy has owned as well. Billy has always impressed me, and when I first met him, he was a young man just out of his teens. He impressed me with his sense of purpose, and if ever I met a young man who was bound to go places, it was Billy. Billy does not dream about things, he does things. And he doesn't think about things happening, he makes them happen. And I think that he's got a really bright future in front of him, but of course we must remember that behind every successful man, there is a successful woman. And Kim has proven herself as an excellent homemaker. I think that she and Billy both share the same positive attributes, and I think together they're going to make for a very happy, long and successful marriage. Thank you very much. It now gives me the greatest of pleasure to ask you to charge your glasses and drink a toast to the bride and the groom. Fucking groom.
Supercharged!
Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to ask Billy now to say a few words.
Well, thanks very much, George. That was a speech that's most appreciated by both Ken and myself. I have a few notes here too, but at the stage of the wedding, they're very hard to see and to think about. On behalf of Kim and myself, we do thank you for coming here today. We appreciate your loyalty and your friendship. We also appreciate the presents that we have received from you, even though we haven't had a chance to see them all yet. I'd like to thank Kim for becoming my wife today. I'm very proud to be her husband. I'm very lucky that Kim has actually stuck with me for at least 6 years, through thick and thin. And once again, I would like to thank you all for coming. And I'll put you on to Alan, my best man. Thank you.
Thank you, Billy. Certainly the second time in my life I've been best man for anybody, and I thought I'd better brush up. You know, amongst certain tribes in South America, it's the responsibility of the best man to ensure the stock count of the dowry, to guarantee the innocence of the bride-to-be, and to supervise the consummation following the ceremony, following with a general announcement to the rest of the tribe afterwards, saying, Kalila au! Roughly translated, it fits! So the festivities can begin. It also says something about here about his duties to the bridesmaids, but surely that can't apply this side of the South Pacific. Coincidentally though, this best man at this tribal wedding, because it is a tribal wedding in this remote group of islands in the colonies, can fulfil some parallel duties. I can't count the goats and the sheep and the pigs to establish the bride's worth, but I can, however, vouch for the stock or cultural integrity, if you like, of the tribes integrated their alliance here today. The Jones clan, here am I, I've got right left here because I really didn't know which side they're going to be on when I wrote this, but here they are on my right. The Jones clan represent the Anglo-Saxon Celt nomads who braved the elements, journeyed to the Antipodes in search of opportunity and adventure. Now, several generations later, through polite socialisation and fate, Bill and Jill have made their post-wartime baby boom contribution to New Zealand in the form of William George Thomas Jones, the genuine Kiwi Ki Taliaate young joker, even played rugby league at school. He's got a sense of humour too, I've got to tell you a little side. He used to have a dog named Silly, and Bill used to come round to my place. And one day, Silly was sitting in front of the fireplace looking at a very important part of his anatomy, keeping it clean. Billy gave me a nudge and he says, gee, Billy, I wish I could do that. I was giving him a biscuit, Billy would probably let you. The stock of the tarpaies on the other side, I got that part right because I knew they'd be on the opposite side, intimates another cultural influence, obviously pleased to greet the colonists and to learn their system of polite socialisation. A prior colonist, and resident culture, the Maori brought ancestral differences into perspective by cross-pollinating. A very gentle expression I recently heard, it doesn't sound as energetic as interbreeding with the colonists and the descendants. Now they say what the world needs now is a great big melting pot. And you can bear witness to the fabulous results of a great recipe. Maureen and Rangi, you have produced an admirable family and a beautiful, gracious and talented daughter who is a shining example of today's true Kiwi bride and devoted mother herself to two healthy, bright and energetic Kiwi boys of tomorrow and beyond. What new cultures will Billy Jr. and Jamie introduce with their brides in a couple of decades? Maybe some Japanese, I've seen a few around here today. Yes, folks, our bride and groom come from good stock, good family lines, good parents. I salute the parents, the bride and the groom. You've done your part extremely well. Now, rather than guarantee the innocence of the bride, I'll testify as to her virtue. Nice word, that. Everybody envies others that have it when they're unaware of what they've got themselves. Kim is brave. She's resourceful, faithful, loyal, caring, conscientious. Already mentioned talented and gracious, didn't I? And certainly female. Everything a perfect bride should be. Billy, you know how lucky you are. And Kim, you're marrying one of the most sincere, genuine, loyal, and loving persons that I've ever been my privilege to have known in many years. To me, Billy and Kim have been as married since I've known them as a couple. They've held this ceremony today, an ancient custom of all races, cultures and creeds, as an affirmation of their devotion and care for each other. Been through some bad times, been through some good times. Copyright Chris Christopherson, I'm sure he doesn't mind. But every day, in every way, their love has nurtured and grown stronger and shows every sign of getting better yet. Now about the consummation bit. There is ample evidence to affirm they have practiced. And they will consummate in the near future, I'm sure. So how about if we continue with the festivities without delay? And I'd like to propose a toast right now to the parents of the bride and groom, which is Bill and Jewel on my right and Rangi and Maureen on my left. Ladies and gentlemen, the parents of the bride and groom.
Hear, hear.
If you haven't drained your glasses, I would especially like to propose a toast to two of the most lovely young ladies here today. They look absolutely stunning. Kim's sisters, as the bridesmaids. A toast to the bridesmaids, folks. Bridesmaids. I'm going to call upon Rangi Tawhai down there, who is going to reply on behalf of...
Just in case you haven't heard me, kia ora. The last speech you just heard is a pretty hard act to follow, so I'll be short and sweet, very sweet, speaking about it. I'm prepared again, but Kim and Billy, I wish you all the best from the bottom of my heart. It's a fantastic wedding. Everything looked beautiful. And into the bridesmaids. It's fantastic. To take after their father, don't you think? No Scots in our family. But before I go on to a toast to the family here, I'd like to welcome our brother-in-law and his family down here from Wellington, and to all our friends that's here today. It's only on two occasions we seem to meet, and a happy one like this and a sad one in funerals, and that's bad. I think we should be meeting more often. Our life is too short. And I thank you very much for being here for my daughter's wedding and my new son-in-law and the parents. I've known Bill for 6 years, Bill and Jill. They sit right behind Billy in his business. Plus Alan, I know Alan. It's good to know friends like that. So, further to do, I'd like to do a toast to the two wee boys here, Billy and young Billy Jr. and James.
Who are boys?
There's the two wee boys.
The boys.
Billy and Jamie.
Salmon and rib chop.
Thank you very much. I'd like to see Billy James.
The waiters are going to serve the main table, and after they have been served, you were invited all to go up to the buffet table. If you just wait, please, until the waiters have served your main table. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Walking down the street saying,
"My baby girl."
Bye. grab a pair of hips and his Kylie LeBoo. And it's the locomotion.
Say he loves. Surprise for you. Yeah.